far as shaman as a title, you don't have record of me giving it, making that self-proclamation before this. The reason that I'm doing it now is because you asked me who I was, and so I'm talking about things more than I ever have before. It wasn't anyone's business before. However, and you'll just deny it, so go ahead, but say, am I lying? Shaman's in my mind. It was something that had been pointed out and stated to me throughout my life. Through spiritual talks that I attended at a really early age with gurus or psychics or shop owners or fellow witches, shamans. Yeah, shamans that, you know, are living nature. Yeah, shamans who are psychonauts. Yeah, people that are spiritually inclined that might not have a title or proper training. It's been always. And I wouldn't have grabbed onto that had I not had to explain so much. But the evidence of it is actually, see, I'm not too worried. The people that are off, what if fake, what if phony, they are fake, they're phony, because the real ones always know. But the evidence has actually been really obvious. Having to sleep in a cemetery, you guys, walking in the dark, walking up the mountain, I went to go up there and sleep alone. No one was there. There's scary people all around. I'm walking up steps in pure dark in a cemetery. In the loony bin when I threw my head back and laughed. And let that laugh come through me when I'm getting threats left and right. And one patient fell on the ground. And the other one ran to his room. Two that were threatening. That life choice to walk that path. You guys are saying she read a book once, so she thinks. No, I walked the path. And it was a conscious choice at the time, deliberate. If you have audio, you hear me say, I just can't do the samsara of this bullshit. There's no point in believing in anyone in this situation. There's no point in believing in these falsehoods. That life is over. You can be as racist and you can be as judgmental about this world. That's really okay. I'm not. The ones that know already know. And the ones that don't will never know. But what I also want to say is look for it in you. It's not so rare to be a shaman. It's not so rare to be a witch. It's not so rare to be a psychic or a healer or any of these divisions or anything. These are things that are important and intrinsic to the end tribe. If you're alone, you're going to know it even better. And so population-wise, I mean, you're looking at 1 out of every 10, out of every 20 people. It's not so rare. it's just with all the sensations around us, distractions, naysayers saying, new age, listen, I love this. So it's so dismissed, new age, as if new makes it not. But what's funny, these new age concepts come from very old things. And it seems like people, as we're getting into a more primal state, are just remembering what we were told to do. How many times have people come up and said you're very courageous? You're very courageous what you're doing, and I go, yeah. But also there's not even another choice. I know me and I know them, and it's just the only way to get us through. And when you know your path, you know your calling, and you know yourself, that's all there is. So even though I cry and you know I kick and scream at some points, do I ever stop? No. But you can say whatever you want. You can say whatever you want. It's new. It's all new concepts. Times of